For our next presenter, 1958 was a big year. That's when he reported to the Chicago Bears as a small but very fast running back. Before I introduce Johnny, many people probably are not aware of the fact that I had an opportunity to play professional football. One play kept me out. It was the fake into the line. That was the only play. I used to yell out, "I don't have it." And I think this, more than anything else, kept me from pro ball and God knows what else. Would you please welcome Channel 2 sportscaster, Mr. Johnny Morse.
Thank you, Bob. I'd just like to say one thing before I do my nominations here. I was just in California for 4 days. The weather wasn't as good as Chicago, and the television wasn't as good as Chicago. Believe me. The nominees in category 4B, Outstanding Achievement for Informational Programming, Single Public Affairs Programs Not Included in the Series, are Illinois, America's Nuclear Burial Ground, Chuck Collins, reporter, producer, Channel 11. Trial by Jury, Joel Daly, host, Jerry Kupcinet, producer, Channel 7. Project Parenting, a special, Lee Phillip, Warner Saunders, Mort Grimm, co-host, Jim Corson, Frank Jackson, co-producers, Channel 2. Ask for the Governor, Ron Hutter, host, Al Snyder, producer, Channel 5. And Mexico Vibra En Chicago, Patricia Urbano, host, Hector Perez, producer, Channel 26. And the winner is... Mexico Vibra En Chicago, Patricia Urbano, host, Hector Perez, producer, WCIU Television, Channel 26.
Thank you. I really didn't think this could happen. I haven't been to confession for a while. I'd just like to thank the Mexican Civic Society for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Se estima que en la actualidad hay más de 500,000 de mexicanos que radican en la ciudad y alrededor de 200,000 en los suburbios y en el estado de Illinois.
We have two more presenters to bring out now. The taller of the two was learning how to fly an airplane 20 years ago. The shorter one was operating her own lemonade stand at age 12 in Milwaukee. Here are Channel 5's weatherman and the hostess of Market Basket on Channel 26, Jim Tilmon and Ruth Graham.
You know, Bob, I listened to that story about that airline captain. I want you to know I'm a captain with American Airlines, and I happen to know some of the other airlines are using that same guy with a CNI dog because they're overbooked, and it works.
Well, hello, Captain.
Hello, how are you? How's the lemonade stand?
Fine, I've been studying economics ever since. But you know, I'm really impressed with you because as a commercial airline pilot and as a TV weather forecaster, you're both in the air as well as on it.
I love the way you said that. That ought to win an Emmy by itself. This is a special night, and I know a lot of these people are anxious to hear about this. The nominees in Category 4C, Outstanding Achievements for Informational Programming, or Conversation Program Series, are John Calloway Interview. John Calloway host, Jerry Goodman, producer, Channel 11. Cup Show, Irv Kupcinet host, Paul Frumkin, producer, Channel 11. Friday Night with Steve Edwards. Steve Edwards host, Howard Schultz, producer, Channel 7. Common Ground. Warner Saunders host, Frank Jackson producer, Channel 2. Ruth?
Chicago 78, Norman Mark host and co-producer, Ray Barnes co-producer, Channel 32. Ron Hunter Today, Ron Hunter host, Britta Ebert Fayette producer, Channel 5. Stock Market Observer, Ben Larson host, Glenn Stewart producer, Channel 26. And My Opinion, Shirley Harris host, Janet Gerlesitz producer, Channel 26.
And I have the winner right here. I tell you everything about this except how to get this thing in. Common Ground, Warner Saunders host, Frank Jackson producer, WBBM-TV.
Me first this year. It was a thrill last year, but it's a bigger thrill this year. I guess of all the people that we ought to be thanking, I guess we must thank our own parent station, Channel 2. And I also want to thank my wife and my family for having the kind of setting that gave me the opportunity to do these kinds of things. I really do appreciate it. Thanks so much, Dom. And to this producer, who's a super guy.
Well, thank you. There are an awful lot of people need to be thanked. This man is foremost. It wouldn't be Common Ground without Warner Saunders. I mean, it is the Warner Saunders show, actually, you know. Speaking of parents, I'd like to thank my mother also, well. And I'd like to thank Dave Nelson and Jamie Bennett and Ed Spray and all those folks in the management of Channel 2, wonderful people. Not to mention a terrific production staff, some of the greatest production assistants in the world, folks like Ken Calhoun, great assistants by Gail Sykovitz, by the way, he's a great producer. I'm really nervous. And everybody in the Community Affairs Department program, thank you very much. I don't take up all
time. Are you still a Southerner in your heart?
In my well, it's so popular to be Southern now.
No, but I mean when it wasn't. I mean, sure, there are people taking on the plastic side of being Southern now because of the presidency of the United States. But does your body feel Southern?
It's an interesting question. I suppose I am in some ways because you get rather defensive when you see people pinning labels on Southerners, just as you do get defensive when you see anyone pinned down to a generality. My father was a remarkable man, and some of the dreadful things to which most people were exposed, I had a chance to be a little free of.
Now here's some more retrospective. If this were 20 years ago, you'd be seeing people like Fahey, Flynn, Frank Reynolds, John Harrington, P.J. Hoff, and Lee Phillips here on Channel 2. That 2 out of 5 is not a bad average. And the big CBS network shows then were I Love Lucy, Gunsmoke, and Ed Sullivan. This is Channel 2's 25th anniversary, and here are some of the station's history.
Hello, I'm John Coughlin, and Channel 2's roots go back to here, the Wrigley Building, the old home of CBS radio station WBBM. Then, 25 years ago, CBS acquired this television station and changed it from Channel 4 to Channel 2. And to get more space, everything was moved across town where Lee Phillip is now.
That's right, John. This has been the home of Channel 2 since 1956, right here at 630 North McClurg Court. The programs are done here and then transmitted to you from the top of the Hancock Building. What would you have seen on Channel 2 in the 50s? Well, we can't sample everything, but here are some of the people you might remember.
Wednesday, during what one correspondent described as some of the roughest minutes of the Eisenhower administration, the president said he personally could not conceive of Mr. Truman doing anything knowingly to damage the country.
First, I'd like to present Mrs. Dorothy Vredenburgh, Secretary of the Democratic National Committee. Dorothy, welcome again.
Thanks, Tom. It's always nice to be with you and to be in Chicago.
Thank you, Dorothy. And the very handsome, dapper gentleman on your left, the one and only Jerome Colonna.
You know, some of last year's blouses have been replaced by a man's tailored shirt, and they come in everything from Oxford cloth to a fancy embroidered silk material.
John Coughlin.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks very much, Bruce Roberts, and you're right. I have never won a thing in my life. I have an Irish sweepstake ticket in my pocket right now. It's as good as gone.
Welcome once again. Once again, this is the first show to In the Bag. It's a panel game based on the proposition that everybody is just a little bit curious.
A real milestone came in 1960. We did one of the great debates between John F. Kennedy and Richard M. Nixon. Many experts felt that Kennedy's showing on television won him the presidency.
I have been in the Congress for 14 years. I have voted in the last 8 years. When the vice president was presiding over the Senate and meeting his other responsibilities, I have met decisions over 800 times on matters which affect not only the domestic security of the United States, but as a member of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. The question really is, which candidate and which party can meet the problems that the United States is going to face in the 60s?
That was 1960. We now have a family of 327 people. And like most families, we have an album of pictures. Here's a look at some of them. Fahey Flynn, before the bow tie.
P.J. Hoff, the weatherman.
A younger Bruce Roberts.
A younger Harry Porterfield.
Johnny Morris, with crew cut.
Walter Jacobson, in the early 60s.
And Bill Kurtis, in the late 60s.
That's just a brief look at some of our history.
And all of us at Channel 2 want to wish a happy 20th birthday to the Chicago TV Academy.